TheDailyMass.com. Experience the Roman Catholic Mass from historic St. Louis Cathedral every day on TheDailyMass.com. His love, anywhere in the world.
I'm Sarah McDonald.
And I'm Jason Angelette. Welcome to Issues in Faith.
Well, we have a big show tonight.
We do.
Lots of guests lined up, so we're going to go ahead and get right to
Let's
it.
Do it.
Well, on June 9th, Our Lady of the Lake Church in Mandeville will host a special meeting for Catholic men, a workshop facilitated by a group called the King's Men.
Joining us by phone is Dave DeNuzzo, Program Director of the King's Men. Thank you, Dave, for being with us. How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great. Thanks for having me on today.
Man, such an amazing ministry, the Kingsmen. I'd like to know a little bit more for the audience, the history and the mission of the Kingsmen.
Sure. Well, the history is pretty grassroots, very organic the way it happened. Two men met at a Theology of the Body conference, and then they started hanging out. They realized that they needed a little bit more. They wanted some brotherhood and some accountability. And so they started meeting regularly, and then it was really bearing fruit for them. So they started inviting other buddies, and then other men started hearing about it. And the one group was too big, so they created two groups, and then those groups continued to grow. And so out of that grew the ministry, and that was about 7 years ago. And the Kingsmen happened just very naturally out of the needs of the men. And then from there, it's grown into a nonprofit lay organization where we mostly focus on men's formation. And we also have some other events that programming that take place as well, but formation's really at the heart of it.
So what are some specific events that y'all put on and resources that you'll provide for these men?
Well, the main thing that we do, again, is those formation groups, and we have approximately 30 that meet around the country. And those are always expanding. So if anybody's happening to hear this and wants a men's group that's really solid, that's about more than just hanging out, that really dives into prayer and then specifically into accountability, that's the group for them. So we have the formation groups. We also are all over the country with speaking, going to men's conferences and so forth. We put on very, very dynamic outdoor retreats called Into the Wild. Into the Wild is a weekend retreat where men, we take them out of the normal life, away from cell phone and email, and we really get to the heart of the man. And it's very sacramentally based, and it's a great experience. There's more on our website. Or you can go specifically to intothewildweekend.com. We have four of those retreats happening this summer, and hopefully, God willing, in 2013, we'll be in Louisiana.
Well, praise God.
And then
some other things we do,
we have a healing retreat, which is coming up brand new this year, and we also, you can find us in front of many sexually oriented businesses where we protest and minister to the men to teach them and help them that there's better out there. And so that's basically a quick overview of the ministry.
Fantastic. I mean, so many ways of formation, fellowship, and then being active, too, to go out there and to help be a true man out there in the world. That's amazing. I mean, we need real fellowship, and I think that's why I believe your ministry is growing so rapidly and so because it's so needed, because we need, as Scripture says, that as iron sharpens iron, so man sharpens his fellow man, and we need that real fellowship in the Lord to help us to grow in our faith and help us to be the King's men. Tell us about, there's an upcoming leaders training workshop at Our Lady of the Lake on June 9th. Could you tell us a little more about that?
Yes, absolutely. So on Saturday, June 9th, at Our Lady of the Lake in Mandeville, we will be having a day-long retreat. It'll go from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. This workshop is intended for any man who wants to come to basically get all the resources and tools that he needs to then go back to his parish and start a group. So the men that will be attending will receive printed materials as well as access to downloads and so forth, and then full-time support from me to take the model that we already utilize
the successful
and take
model.
It back into their parish.
That's fantastic. So, what would you say to somebody who's watching right now, who's hearing you talk about the King's Men and being more involved, or and maybe they're not there yet, or they just feel like, I don't know if this is for me. What words of encouragement can you give them to come to this workshop, to taste and see what this is all about, and to help them somehow mobilize this effort here in our state?
That's a great question. There are always those men out there that feel that they are not good enough, not ready right now, not equipped. Brothers, I will tell you, we have a brotherhood that is strong of men that are just like you, men that are only strong because of Christ and because of these brothers around them. You can join in that brotherhood too. This is not something we just say to be fake or to try to draw men in a conniving way. This is real, and I believe that if you come and you hear about what we're doing and you see the sincerity in which we and the men all over the country are doing it, you will say, that is for me. That is what I want. And let's say a man comes, and for whatever reason, it's just not for him. There's no obligation there. We want to make men's ministry really easy, really practical, so that it's affecting men in a positive way, that it's building our church, and that goodness takes over.
Praise God. Dave, thank you so much for all that you're doing in your ministry. This is truly a man's man ministry, and God bless you, and looking forward to having you close by on June 9th. So thanks so much, and talk to you soon. For more information about the King's Men or to register, please go online to www.thekingsmen.org, and we'll be right back.
What will the world ask of them? Whatever it is, they'll be prepared to answer. Because in a safe and disciplined environment, Louisiana Catholic schools shape tomorrow's leaders. Catholic students are rising. 99% graduate. Almost all go to college. They'll earn higher wages, be community involved, more tolerant of diverse views. And the world will be better because of them. Louisiana Catholic schools, in a class of their own.
The heart of Woman's New Life Center is its outreach to women in unplanned pregnancies, especially those who are seeking an abortion. Our professional counseling services, combined with free ultrasound tests, provide each woman with the nurturing she needs while also revealing her unborn child to her. For more information about the life-saving work of Woman's New Life Center, call 504-831-3117 or visit womansnewlife.com.
I'm here today inside historic St. Louis Cathedral, a place where WLAE has broadcast the daily mass for more than 25 years.
A recent PBS ruling ensures that this valuable service will continue on WLAE for those looking for daily inspiration, and for the many who are homebound or in our area hospitals who can't attend Mass. But in order to continue to provide the Mass every day, we need your financial support now more than ever. I'm asking you to please consider donating today. We have numerous partnership opportunities available. For as little as $32 a month, you can help fund the televising of the Daily Mass, a program that lifts the spirit and enriches the lives of so many of our viewers. And for a donation of $50 or more, we will send you this beautiful signed poster of St. Louis Cathedral as our gift. Please send your contributions to WLAE-TV, 3330 North Causeway Boulevard, Metairie, Louisiana, 7002, or to donate online, log on to WLAE.com and click on the picture of St. Louis Cathedral. For more information on partnership opportunities, call 504-866-7411.
At WLAE, we've worked hard to keep the Mass on the air. Now we need your financial support to keep it going. I know that you'll help us if you can. Thank you, and God bless.
The summer season can be one of great challenges for families struggling with hunger. Joining us tonight to talk about what Second Harvest Food Bank is doing to help in the community, including some fun and quacky events, is Mr. Corey Howard of Second Harvest Food Bank. Thanks so much for being with us tonight.
Thank you for having us.
Well, we want to start off by kind of focusing on some of the challenges that is facing Second Harvest Food Bank in helping families struggling with hunger.
Sure, absolutely. You know, this time of year, we're approaching the end of school. And with the end of school means that families that already strained on their budget for food, they're going to now have to feed their children 2 and 3 times a day. And so with those challenges, we know that one solution to that is to be able to set up through our summer feeding program to be able to set up an opportunity for those children to be able to get the meals that they would normally not get. And that's, we have a relationship with summer programs, and through those summer programs allow them to, allow us to feed them. And this summer we're actually looking at feeding over 240,000 individuals.
Wow.
This summer to children in the community that would otherwise not have that opportunity to have that meal twice a day.
That's a big impact on the community, especially when you're struggling. You know, the Archbishop is talking about the new Battle of New Orleans. So much of that starts with meeting those basic needs, like hunger.
When absolutely.
You're hungry, it's very hard to bring control to your life and this, that, and the other. But you're facing some challenges, some cuts on the federal level as well that we're going to be calling on the community to help you with.
Correct. And not only, as we know, the economic times that we're in, but in addition to that, we know that, you know, part of that challenge is through negotiations with the USDA, where we're able to get food to those that need it. That is down, that food amount is down almost 2 million pounds. And so for us to look at such a significant downturn in the amount of food that we're able to give out, we do rely on the community to be able to step up and say, you know, what can I do to be able to help? And it comes in many different ways. We're asking individuals to volunteer. I mean, we're in dire needs right now of some immediate help volunteering. And then also, funds, but also the ability to provide that, you know, the food and support Second Harvest to be able to get to those families.
Sure, and as I mentioned in our intro, there's some special events this past weekend. We had the letter carriers food drive, which is successful, and people, if they're watching tonight on Thursday, can still turn their food in tomorrow on Friday the 18th.
Correct.
But coming up this weekend is that quacky event that I mentioned,
that's
the Rubber
right.
Duck Derby. Tell us about that.
It is our Rubber Duck Derby. It is, as you mentioned, this coming Sunday. It's part of the last day of Bayou Boogaloo, which is out of Bayou St. John. Mm-hmm. And it's quite an interesting event because it is the only duck event in town. And basically what we ask is that for $5, you could adopt a duck, or $25 for like a 6-pack of ducks, that you could adopt ducks, and your name basically goes on the duck, and we dump all the ducks at the same time into the Bayou St. John. And the ducks, as they move down the bayou, one duck will finish first. And that winner wins through the generosity of Benner Ford and Benner Chevrolet, can win a brand new car.
Wow.
And so so that is the motivation, a brand new car. But in addition, all proceeds go to Second Harvest, allows us to do stuff like this summer feeding. So that's this Sunday through Bayou Boogaloo.
So how many ducks are you expecting to have? How many have you had in the past traveling down Bayou St. John? That has to be a sight.
Sure, it is. It's we're expecting about 15,000 ducks. And
wow.
So as you see it, I even mentioned that it kind of turns Bayou St. John into a little bit brighter yellow than it normally is. But it's a great event in that you get to see the ducks dumped into the bayou. And 15,000 ducks being able to go out into it's actually really decent chances to win a car. So
yeah, that's not bad. And there are several other prizes, and people can find out more information. But I want to thank you very much for being with us tonight. Rubber Duck Derby is again this weekend.
Correct.
And there are multiple opportunities to help Second Harvest throughout
correct.
The year.
Correct. You could go online at on Second Harvest website, and you'd be able to register for the ducks, but also you could go out to the festival and adopt a duck, and we appreciate all the help.
Very good. Well, thanks so much, Corey, for being with us.
All right, thank you so much.
Again, the Rubber Duck Derby is this weekend, May 20th, at the Bayou Boogaloo on Bayou St. John. You can learn more online at www.no-hunger.org. We'll be right back.
grief and loss resulting from an abortion can be overwhelming. Many women and men need a safe place to heal. The Woman's New Life Center is that place. We treat each woman and man with the utmost respect and dignity. We offer individual counseling and referrals to post-abortion retreats that offer a psychological and spiritual approach to healing. Call 504-831-3117 or visit womansnewlife.com.
We never forget our best teachers, the ones who do so much more than teach. They inspire and insist we bring our best in everything we do. We find those mentors in our Catholic schools. It's why Catholic school graduates consistently go on to college, land better jobs, embrace faith, and lead. Louisiana Catholic Schools, in a class of their own.
As we continue to honor our Mother Mary in this month of May, we are joined by Mr. George and Mrs. Gay Hernandez of the Legion of Mary. Thank you so much for being with us tonight.
Thank you.
So tell us about what is the Legion of Mary and what is its mission?
Okay. First, I'd like to start off with a quote from Pius X, who said, quote, "I would conquer the world if I had an army which recites the rosary," unquote. On the strength of this conviction, on September 7, 1921, they knelt for the first time around the Virgin statue, the first contingent of this army, which now encircles the globe, the Legion of Mary. The object of the Legion of Mary is the glory of God, true holiness of its members, and for their own sanctification.
Fantastic.
Okay, the Legion of Mary was founded by Frank Duff in Dublin, Ireland in 1921, and he realized how important the lay apostolate was in the church. Mm-hmm. Cause is coming up for beatification, still pending. He was first in the St. Vincent de Paul Society, which performs corporal works of mercy, such as paying rent, paying light bills, giving food. Now, the Legion of Mary does the spiritual works of mercy, mm-hmm. and George, in a few minutes, will tell you what some of the works that we do. The Legion of Mary is the largest lay Catholic organization in the world.
Fantastic.
With over 15 million active and auxiliary members.
Wow.
And it's been active in the New Orleans area for about 60 years now.
Praise God. So tell us, Mr. George, what does the Legion of Mary do? What's their mission?
Well, first I'd like to say that the Legion of Mary takes its name from the Roman Legion, mm-hmm. Which is known for its structure, its loyalty, its discipline, and its courage. Now, the highest level of the Legion of Mary is called the Concilium, and that's in Dublin, Ireland, mm-hmm. which is the headquarters. And then after that, then you have the lower councils, which would be Senatus, Regia, Comitium, Curia, and then the basic group is the parish group, which is called a Presidium.
And these names all come from?
From the Latin, from the Roman army, yes.
Yes.
From the Roman Legion, I'm mm-hmm. saying, okay. Now, here in New Orleans, we have a regia, mm-hmm. of which we are, wife and I, are president and vice president. And under this umbrella of the regia here in New Orleans, we have five curia, one comitium, and then for the whole state is 62 presidium.
Wow.
Which is parish level, at the
sure,
parish level.
Sure.
So that's, now some of the works that we do are spiritual works of mercy, like we mentioned before. It's like visiting the sick at hospitals, nursing homes, and acting as extraordinary ministers at these facilities. Mm. And teaching CCD classes, acting as sponsors for this RCIA program, making the parish census, enrolling the Sacred Heart in the homes, individual evangelization and crowd contact, prison visitations, dissemination of Catholic literature, such as miraculous medals and scapulars, and rosaries. Leading the rosary in prayers at wakes and funerals when requested by the pastor. and whatever else the pastor wants us to do in the nature of spiritual works of mercy. Excuse me. So the Legion of Mary, okay, so that's what we do in the Legion of Mary.
This is fantastic. I mean, we're running out, close out of time, but there's so much that the Legion of Mary is involved with in the community, in the parish, for the church. I mean, this goes to the heart of what Christ talked about and the spiritual works of mercy. And so I guess if someone is interested in learning more about the Legion of Mary, or would like to be involved, like to help out and be a part of the Legion, how can they do that?
We're going to give our numbers later. You can contact us, and we do get it started by the way we do it is go to the parish itself on the extension committee, and we contact the priest. Mm-hmm. We speak at all the masses, and if we get the people that are interested, we'll start the Legion there, and we stay with them for 3 months. They're on probation, and then they're on their own. But if you contact us, we'll get you started if you're interested.
Well, fantastic. We really have to go, but wow, what an amazing ministry, an amazing apostolate here in our area, even where y'all are doing so much for the church.
Oh,
so thank y'all so much for being here, sharing your witness, and God bless you in all that you're doing.
Thank you, Jason, very much.
Again, for more information, you can call Gay or George Hernandez at 504-583-1024, or you can email them at ghernandez12@cox.net. You can also find more information online at legionofmary.org. And we'll be back.
Women's New Life Center, reproductive health care is about more than the body. It's also about the soul. WNLC's newest program, Hope Fertility Care Center, provides effective, morally acceptable ways to plan a family, monitor fertility, and assess gynecologic health. For more information about the Women's New Life Center, call 504-831-3117 or visit womansnewlife.com.
Imagine America's largest stage, dark. Or the nation's biggest schoolhouse, empty. Or the greatest library of documentary programming, closed forever. It could happen if funding for PBS is eliminated. Find out more about the threat to PBS at 170millionamericans.org.
Priests from the North Shore were recently gathered together in one room in Mandeville. The reason? So they could hear a big thank you in the form of dinner and wine. Jenna Gross was there as the North Shore chapter of the Catholic Foundation showed its appreciation to its spiritual leaders in the church.
They were the center of attention. Priests from 17 parishes on the North Shore here to hear a thank you.
Oh my goodness, don't they really need it? And they really catch it. They catch it a lot of times from all sides. But there's a time we figured we would say, come and have a dinner with us, let's enjoy a glass of wine, and let us tell you that how much we appreciate you.
The honorees modestly accepted the kindness, but say their parish family show them love every day.
People do appreciate it. They realize the importance of what we do as priests and the way that we try to serve them. And they're very appreciative of that.
The North Shore chapter of the Catholic Foundation, along with generous donors, hosted this event. Archbishop Hannon started the foundation years ago to help charity and philanthropy in the Archdiocese. It helps direct gifts and contributions from parishioners with a motto of, a gift today is a promise of tomorrow.
So philanthropy is a much larger picture, a vision of the future, if you would, Jan, that allows us to work in conjunction with our churches, our schools, the multitude of ministries within the Archdiocese, to help our donors and their supporters do more than just give charitably for the immediate needs, but also to help them develop their dreams and their passions for these organizations through planned gifts, which the foundation helps facilitate.
Many of those here help or are funded by the foundation. For example, the Pro-Life Bioethics Defense Fund.
You know, unborn children are our clients, but they don't have a lot of money. And so we depend on the generous donors that come through the Catholic Foundation. It's just absolutely key.
On this night, the foundation, along with its generous donors from different parishes, put their efforts into appreciation.
You are really successors of St. Paul, and you're all chosen instruments to carry the name of Jesus and proclaim his name, you know, here in both St. Tammany as well as in Washington parishes. And I just want to thank you for your commitment and your dedication to accomplish this here on the North Shore.
And then these men who have dedicated their lives to the work of God turned around the appreciation with a thank you of their own.
So it is appropriate that we honor these men who have given their lives and who day after day lead you and serve you and love you and shepherd you. But I also know that they join me this evening in honoring you and in thanking you for your dedication to Christ and to a life of discipleship.
About 24 priests were honored here. They shepherd a growing population north of the lake.
We have about 26% of the total population of Catholics in the entire Archdiocese right here in the North Shore. So it's very highly populated, and we're just very proud of our North Shore and our North Shore priests.
And they got a small taste of that pride as the church's flock fed the shepherds. I'm Janet Gross for Issues in Faith.
For more information about the Catholic Foundation, North Shore and South Shore, call 504-596-3045. Or you can find them through the Archdiocesan website.
If you have a question for us or an idea that you'd like to see on air, please write to us at Issues in Faith, 3330 North Causeway Boulevard, Suite 345, Metairie, Louisiana 7002. Or you can email us at questions@wlae.com. Plus, if you missed an episode, you can catch up online at www.archdiocese-no.org.
And that's our program for this evening. For all of us at Issues in Faith, thanks for watching.
We'll be back next week. Hope you join us again soon. Until then, God bless. We'll